I'm Yanely Espinal with another FinCap Friday brought to you by NextGen Personal Finance. When people want to make their money grow, they usually shop around for the highest return on investment they can get. Savings accounts don't usually give that much interest, but they do protect your money. So people who want higher return usually go shop for stocks. Those can be risky because it's impossible to predict exactly what will happen next in the stock market. So that's where bonds come in. People like bonds because they're not as risky as stocks. Bonds don't give you ownership in companies like stocks do. Instead, you lend your money to a company or to the government and they promise to pay you back later with some interest, usually more than you'd get at the bank, but less than you would get with stocks. Well, at least that's how it's supposed to work. In the summer of 2019, there was a storm of media coverage about negative interest rate bonds. So imagine that you buy a bond for $100 and you have a one-year term. After a year, you come back to collect your money, but you only get back $99. That is a negative 1% return on investment. With negative 1% return bonds, you would lose a dollar for every $100 you invest. So why would anybody sign up for that? Well, here's what you need to know. Negative interest rate bonds spread throughout Switzerland, Germany, France, Japan, and a lot of other countries just in the summer of 2019. Many of the people buying negative interest rate bonds do it because they're afraid of investing in riskier investments like stocks, because then they might lose even more money. So they play it safe. But why not just take the money out of the bond market when it's negative and put it in the bank? If only it were that simple. When economic growth slows down a lot, bonds aren't the only thing feeling the pain. The banks feel it too, and they lower interest rates also. Or worse, they start charging fees to people who want to put a lot of money away in the bank. So what's the best thing to do when interest rates are negative? Well, experts say you should wait it out for the storm to pass and interest rates to rise again slowly, just like the sun.